Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video, we are going to take a look at the Chronicles of Narnia, the Disney Store PVC figures of the White Witch and her army. I actually used to have this set when I was younger, but of course I played with it and they either got lost or broken or left behind. So I wanted to get this set mainly because I really love the White Witch. She's an awesome villain. So I thought I would review this set today. So in this set you get obviously the White Witch and some of her team members. So I thought we would go ahead and take a look at the White Witch herself first. So this is the White Witch in her battle outfit. She wears a couple different outfits in the movie, but this is what she wears at the end because the snow's all melted and she doesn't need a coat or anything. I really like this figure actually. They have all no articulation, they're just PVC figures, but the detail on her is really nicely done. The hair and the crown detail is very nicely done. I think this is supposed to be Aislinn's mane when she thinks she's killed him. The detail on her hair is nicely sculpted. The detail on the dress is also nicely sculpted. It actually does look like real chains, and the texturing is nice. It does feel like real chains as well. And you can see all the folds throughout it, and you can see the dragging effect. And she does have two swords. Now, when this first came, I actually had to glue her arm back in, and I had to glue the sword back. So, I knew it was going to come like that because this fella did put it that way, but the swords look very cool. I think the face does look like Tilda Swinton, somewhat. I think it, you know, obviously could have been better, but it does resemble her. So she's a really nicely done figure. And then there is, it says Disney Walden China. So, very cool. Next we have her wolf. I think his name is Morin. Something like that. It's her head wolf. He's very nicely done too. Very nice details on him. He's sculpted nice. He has different paint washes through his fur. He is on a rock, as you can see. And is hollow. So he's pretty cool as well. Next, we have her head dwarf, and I think his name is Ginnebrick. I always forget. Not a fan of this character, really. He was kind of annoying through the movie, but he looks nice too. He's small because he is a dwarf, and he's holding a knife and his axe. And this is when he's in battle too, and he's nicely sculpted. You can see his long beard, and his you can see some hair sticking out there, and you can see his chains as well. Oops, and he's pretty cool. Not really a fan of him though. I'm happy when he dies in the movie. And then we have a goblin. I may guess this is, I really don't know, but he looks pretty good as well. He's creepy, his face is creepy. You can see he has some fur necklace or whatever he's wearing, maybe lion's fur. And then you can see his spine on his back with some hair hanging down. And you can see his tunic or whatever, and you can see his toenails right there. You can see he's on a grassy base, as well as the dwarf is too. And he is holding a spear of some sort. I'm not sure what you really call that. So he is pretty creepy. I think out of all the monsters, I might like him the best. Then we have some kind of Cyclops warrior. I really don't know the name of him from the movie. So when I first got him, he came off his base, and unfortunately I didn't line up the feet good, so he's not really fully on his base, but he's on there. But the detail on him is pretty good too. You can see the armor detail, which is pretty nicely done. He's holding some kind of axe. You can see his face right there. Looks pretty creepy. So yes, he's pretty nice in his boots. And then you get some kind of a bull warrior. I'm not sure what these are called. I'm sure they have a name, but I just can't remember right now. But he has pretty nice length and detail. He's actually the biggest figure in the... Well, actually the White Witch, because of her hair, is the biggest figure. But he is the nice... He's very nicely done. You can see details on him. You can see little symbols. I wonder if that's the White Witch's symbol. You can see nicely sculpted fur. He is on a base like everyone else. You can see his face. There it is, a bull face. And he's also holding a bigger axe, which is very nicely sculpted. So, that's all the figures. I like the set. Obviously, my favorite figure from the set is the White Witch. She's kind of the reason I wanted it. I think it's the best figure in the set, but it's really nice to have her posed next to her army. You probably can find this set on eBay. I do recommend it if you're a Narnia fan. Remember, they just have no articulation fan. They have no articulation, so they're just little statues for display. Let me know what you think of this Narnia set. I love Narnia. And who are your favorite Narnia characters or character? Mine is the White Witch and Mr. Edmund here. I love Edmund. So, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know what you think of the set. As always, all my information is down below. And until the next video, I will see you guys later. Okay, bye. You think you can stop me? First of all, you're not only a traitor to your brothers and sisters, but now you're a traitor to me, and your blood will be on my sword. I am a hero. A true hero, and I will not let you win. I told you I wouldn't let her win. She's dead. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.